of Seagulls. This is a great track. It's quintessential early 80s guitar tone, even if it's not identical in every way to what A Flock of Seagulls had on the recording. I think it's a great starting point and jumping off point for any kind of 80s tone that you might want to build. Paul Reynolds, the guitar player for A Flock of Seagulls, had a pretty simple rig. I couldn't find a lot about it in researching. I did see a couple of pictures of him with a pair of twin Roland JC120s and a Roland RE501 connecting those in stereos. Couldn't find a lot of information about other pedals that he used, so I'm kind of just winging it by ear to sort of match up the sound. And that's the kind of setup I have in Helix for this. Now, the Helix doesn't have a Roland RE501, but it does have a Roland RE201 and some other pedals that I was able to sort of mix together in a mishmash to create some of that magic of the RE501. So that's what we're dealing with here. We've got six different snapshots, and I'm going to demonstrate all six of those for you in isolation without the backing track. The first snapshot we're going to look at is used for the intro. It has those heavy dotted eighth delayed repeats. That sounds like this, played alone. So you can hear the repeats are a lot heavier when the band is not playing. The band would, or the backing track, whatever you're playing with, would tend to cover up the last couple of repeats or so. That's okay. That's the way it's set up and intended to work. The next snapshot we're going to look at is for the second half of the intro, and that's for these long, sustained, distorted chords, and it sounds like this. I'll just roll that off there. So the delay is pretty much gone on that. It has a doubler, so it sounds like multi-tracked guitars, and I think it does a great job capturing that sort of early 80s magic distortion that's on a lot of this genre of music. Now we are going to take a look at the verse snapshot. On the recording, the verses kind of live in this magic place between clean and dirty, and I've tried to capture some of that here. There is a little bit of grit, which to me sounds like overdriving the front end of the RE501, but I have no idea if Paul Reynolds may have used some kind of overdrive pedal in front of it. I am using a little bit of extra gain into the delay on the Helix. I'm using the EP booster and some things like that to try to get the distortion just right. Played alone, I'm going to show you what that sounds like. A note on the part I'm playing. I know that that the rhythm part I'm playing for the verses is a little bit different than what you'll see in most of the tutorials and most of the people on YouTube that show how to play this part. It's even a little bit different than recordings of Paul Reynolds himself in live performances with A Flock of Seagulls. But generally, what I like to do is listen to the studio recording so that I can capture the entire energy of the song instead of just trying to mimic a particular person's live performance. So, that said, this snapshot for the verses comes out sounding like this. Because that's when we go into the next snapshot, which is the sound for the choruses of that song. It's pretty simple, and it ends up sounding like this. You hear there's just kind of one repeat on the delay. It's not a very delayed part. But what it has is a lot of fast modulation, which even though the the drive itself is dialed back, the modulation makes it actually sound a little bit more overdriven. Right after the second chorus, it goes into this vamp that just drones 16th notes on a C note. When played alone, that snapshot sounds like this. And you can hear there's a couple of delay repeats, but when you get those 16th notes going, they build up on themselves, and that's what causes the sound to sound even a little bit more flangey as I'm playing it. That vamp then, of course, ends and fades into the solo part, and that's the last snapshot I have to show you. And that solo, when played alone, comes out like this. And there you have it. A Flock of Seagulls. I ran so far away, I couldn't get away. But hopefully, I won't get away from you guys. Hit the like button. Hit the subscribe button. Head on over to my website. See if there's any things you want to check out or grab from me there to support me. And I'll see you all in the next video, which hopefully will be soon.